The second target of SDG 11 is to improve transport systems, notably by expanding public transport, with special attention to disabled, elderly, and vulnerable members of society. This is a big topic. How can all types of urban residents navigate the city efficiently and safely? Designing transportation infrastructure for walkers, bikers, buses, and trains is the most sustainable, long-term solution to connecting urban residents with their environment and reducing fossil fuel emissions. Robert Potter wrote that if there is a single word that characterizes the urban transport system of Amman, it is congestion. Amman currently has 0% high-capacity public transportation, which is the reason for their constant traffic jams and for their high level of fossil fuel emissions per capita. In Dar es Salaam, there is also a traffic problem, but the residents designed public transport options like daladalas and motorcycle taxis, which save road space and are more affordable. In Bangalore, 42% of the population lives within half a kilometer of public transportation options that run every 20 minutes. However, it is only a small area of the city that is serviced. Traffic congestion in Lima is a signal that the city should provide more efficient services and infrastructure. Currently, the average commuting time for workers is 1 hour and 45 minutes. Lastly, it is important to mention Detroit. Because of the city's low density and lack of buses and trains, poor people in the city spend too much of their salary on car ownership and gas. These measurements show how designing cities for car movement over the past century has led to global petroleum dependency and increasing emissions. In 2014, over 20% of the global carbon dioxide emissions came from transportation means.